draws four
there, and we'll have an icing against Philadelphia, against Boston, as Jonathan took a run and took a punch at DuPont, and there's Jonathan should go off for roughing as DuPont did not wisely retaliate.
Oh, well, Bridgman come in and is coming after Stan Jonathan now, and they're really throwing the punches at each other.
And what I'm worried about here is a crucial third man in.
That could be called, but now Jonathan's picked up and just pulled Bill Bridgman to the ice. Now the linesmen have got in there, and Jonathan's got a couple of good right hands in on Mel Bridgman. But Andre DuPont was going back for an icy call. It was somewhat reminiscent of the play that Dave Hoyta did on Peter McNabb of the Bruins in the last game. Touching the icing up, coming in and taking a check on him. And then when DuPont said something to him, turned around and punched DuPont in the side of the head, who's being looked at by the trainer. Now Jonathan is going as Bridgman's getting up. Bridgman came over to stick his neck in there and say something to Jonathan. But now I think Bobby Schmaltz is talking to referee John McCauley and wondering why it's not third man in. All started as DuPont touched up the puck, and that play there is really, even when Hoyta did it, it's a cheap shot. You don't have to do that. That's when Jonathan turned around and punched DuPont in the eye. He's still being looked at by Matt DiPaolo, the physiotherapist of the Flyers. But Jonathan was going to be off for a penalty, and that's when Bridgman came in and didn't want the Bruins to get away with anything like that. We'll have to see what the call is, but as Gene mentioned, it could be a possible third man in situation by Bridgman. But Bridgman got a couple of pretty good right hands in, but it was hitting the helmet of Jonathan, and then Jonathan got loose and was trying to get some good shots in and just picked up Bridgman and put him to the ice, and that's when he jumped on him, and that's when he got most of his good punches in.
Could well be that John McCauley calls it really two clear-cut separate incidences, and Bridgman did not jump.